Hello, today I will show a study by Jan Timman, the Dutch over the board grandmaster and endgame study composer. He sent the study to the first Armenia Cup in 2017, section B, which was a free section, but had composers had to send the study to both sections, A and B, if they wanted to participate. And this actually shows the content of A, which is that both sides sacrifice a piece. Jan Timman won the second prize in section B with this study. Why this to move and draw? And the struggle of both sides is about capturing the white queen on h1. White can try to prevent all threats with bishop b7, but it is not enough to win. Bishop c2, bishop c6, rook a1 check, king b7, rook b1 check, king a8, bishop e3, and the queen is captured. That's just one example. Black will always be able to capture the queen with similar maneuvers. Another variation that is not working is rook e5. That means rook e6 from the initial position to e5. Then we have bishop c2, rook g5 check, king f2, bishop b7, bishop e4, rook b5, rook c8 check, king a7, king f1 check, king a6. Spectacular now, rook c7 with the checkmate threat on a7 if white does anything. So you can just wait. The general exchange on b7 follows, and after king f2, and if white plays the g pawn, f3 follows, and then knight e4, knight g3, knight takes h1, black wins. We will get to this position again later to prove that black wins, but the best move in this position is rook c6. Black has nothing better than to take on c6, which deflects his rook from the first rank, but he still has the counterplay with king f2 and so on later. White plays bishop b7, and now black decides to sacrifice his rook, rook a6 check, bishop takes a6, bishop f3 check. And now an important decision has to be made. If white just takes on f3, king f2 follows, and there is nothing to prevent knight h5 and knight g3 with a black queen. Even though the material is equal, white will have troubles with his pawns, cannot save them both on f3 and h3, and black wins easily. I will show just one such variation, for example bishop c8, anticipating what is to follow, knight h5, bishop g4, knight g3, queen takes g1, for example, is the only move, but black remains with the knight. And with king and knight, he will easily take the pawns. There is no way to exchange the queen for the knight, or otherwise white could draw. So after bishop f3 check, the better solution, the real solution, but the better move is bishop b7. Black has to get rid of the bishop on f3, because otherwise bishop takes f3 would follow. So bishop takes b7 check, and now we get to the main point of the study. If white plays the obvious move king takes b7, then black plays king f2, and notice that we had the position earlier. White has to play some waiting move, for example king c7, which is actually a bad square, as we will see. knight e4, g3, f3, the queen has to be captured by black, so he does not want to open the cage. G takes h4, knight g3, h5, knight takes h1 check, not check, h6, bishop h2 check, now we have to check, king b7, bishop e5, and black will have the pawn on g7 in the end, promote his pawn, and he will win. Other squares for the white king are similarly bad, but for other reasons. For example, if we go to a6 or a8, the play could continue knight e4, g3, f3, g takes h4, knight g3, h5, knight takes h1, h6, king g2, and we see black has the check on f1, which is actually not necessary, I think. But it gives him a good extra tempo, which makes the win even easier. Other squares are also not good. For example, if we go king a8, avoiding everything else, the same maneuver plays out, which is leading to black capturing the queen again. h6, and now black again can play king g2, h takes g7, f2, g8 queen, and the square is very bad, as we see, because for example queen d5 check, queen f3, I'm sorry, of course not queen actually, king h2, and black is two pieces up and will win eventually. It will take a while, but he does win. So the question is, what is different after white playing the spectacular move king b8? Well, the position after king f2, the queen has to be caged. King takes b7 is a mutual zugzwang. That means the white king stands perfect on b7, but only on b7. Now black is to move and not white, so the king can remain on b7. Black plays knight e4. The play continues as we saw. g3, f3, g takes h4, knight g3, h5, knight takes g1, h6. Now black has no way to win this position. For example, king g3, h takes g7, f2, g8 queen, f1 queen, queen d5 with a draw. Or the draw is not obvious, unfortunately, but if for example king h2, white can just play g7, and black has no way of winning the pawn. If the white king was on a8, for example, queen a1 check, yay! And if it was on c8, there would be queen takes h3 check, and so on. But here on b7, the white king stands perfect, it is shielded from most checks, there is nothing black can do. So the game is a draw. And I think this is a really spectacular idea. And unfortunately, it is very difficult to see that the game is a draw in the end. But the main point of king b8 and the mutual sacrifices make this a study to remember, in my opinion. So let's go through the critical position again. King b8. King f2, and only now king takes b7, because after king takes b7 immediately, king f2 will follow, and white is to move, but his king stands perfect on b7 in the end, as we can see in the final position, but not then on any other square. And I very much like this study. I don't like that the ending is difficult to for a practical player to comprehend, but the study overall is very nice in my opinion, and I wanted to share it with you. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.